Cluth, where's the team? It's time to do the news.
News team, assemble!
News team, assemble! News team, assemble!
You ready?
Let's go, guys. We gotta start the news.
Okay.
Kid Ink's new album comes out January 7th.
That's 2014. Shout out Cable.
Everyone should go cop it.
Whoop, whoop. Let's get into it.
Juniors, the next SAT to take place at NHS is January 25th. The registration deadline is December 27th. If you plan to attend a four-year college, you will want to take this college entrance exam. Register at sat.org/register. If you qualify for free or reduced lunch, see your counselor for a fee waiver to pay for your test.
The GSA would like to congratulate and thank two winners of the Ally Teacher of the Year Award, Danielle Balania and Allison Morgenson. These two teachers are outstanding in their support of all students.
The Multicultural Club wants to thank everyone who donated toys during our drive. The Noblesville Fire Department is happy to be the recipients of your generosity. Happy holidays.
Hey Katie, do you know Pete Freeman?
Of course I do. Who doesn't know Pete?
Did you know that he created the club, Thank Bank? Lindsay Sisk and Sam Fields tell you more.
There are students who have been taking the time to thank people in the community through Thank Bank.
Thank Bank is a club that I started around February of last year, predicated around thanking members in the community who genuinely deserve to be thanked, who've kind of gone under the radar for whatever reasons.
I joined Thank Bank because it feels good giving thanks back to someone who probably can't repay you, like teachers. They're just giving you education, you really can't repay them back.
Thank Bank is a fun way to give back to the community, and anyone is welcome to join.
If you want to get involved in Thank Bank, you can contact me, Pete Freeman, or you can talk to Miss Morgenson, who's in room 113.
Thank Bank members would now like to take some time to thank people in our school.
Coach Clark and Coach John, both of those are very good coaches and very good teachers that take a sincere interest in their students' lives to help them out.
Miss Morgenson, she's probably my favorite teacher. She's the best. I love her. She's awesome.
For NHS News, this is Lindsay Sisk and Sam Fields.
Well, that was awesome, I guess.
Is there any way maybe you could lend me some money? Maybe like $20 million?
Nah, Rosie's doesn't pay me enough. You should know since you work with me.
Doesn't matter. I kind of want and kind of need $20 million right now.
Life is full of disappointments.
I guess. NHS, stick around for sports with the Mandrill Sisters after the break.
It's the happiest season of all. With those holiday greetings and gay happy meetings when friends come to call. It's the happiest season of all. There'll be parties for hosting, marshmallows for toasting, and caroling out in the snow. There'll be scary ghost stories and tales of...
What's up, what's up?
You ready for finals this week?
I'm so hyped. We only have one class all day, and it's about to be sick.
Yeah, but we have finals.
What?
It's finals week.
Nah.
Well, I'm 100% sure it's finals week.
I'll believe it when I see it. This week is finals week at NHS, but who needs to study? Nobody. That's why you need to go out and support your Miller athletes. Your Miller swimmers and divers will be up at Yorktown on Friday. Your varsity wrestlers will be up at HSC on Tuesday. Girls varsity basketball plays away at HSC tonight. Freshman boys basketball plays Tuesday at Brownsburg and Friday at home against Jeff. Your JV boys basketball team plays today at HSC and Friday at home against Jeff. And last, but definitely not least, your varsity boys basketball team who plays Jeff at home on Friday. Go out and support your Millers this week.
Good luck in your finals, NHS.
Here's some Miller trivia to get your mind off of those finals.
It is a fact that finals are this week, man.
I'm calling your bluff on this one.
Whatever.
Jarrell, what was the last state championship here in Noblesville and when?
Y'all feel me? It was 2003.
Well, what sport?
Basketball, my homie.
Wrong. When was the last state championship in Noblesville and what sport?
Girls golf in 2012.
Wrong. Weston. When was the last state championship at Noblesville and what sport?
Boys golf, 2010.
No. When do you think the last state championship at Noblesville was and what sport was it?
I'd say 1927 in hoops and basketball.
No. Pat, when was the last state championship at Noblesville and what sport?
I'm gonna have to go with 1999 boys golf.
98-99.
Correct.
Back to back state.
Hi, I'm Leah.
And I'm Tanya.
And we're lucky enough to be studying computer science.
Hi, I'm Tanya.
We think it's terrible that 90% of schools don't teach it.
They definitely didn't offer it at my high school.
Thanks.
So we're trying to make this video to show that anybody can learn. We want to get 10 million students to do the Hour of Code.
Hour of Code.
Hour of Code.
The Hour of Code.
Hour of Code.
Hour of Code.
Hour of Code.
The Hour of Code!
How do you get him to get to the sunflower? He needs to do some actions.
I got it.
Hey! Oh.
And then we'll run it and see what happens.
Amazing.
Ah, there we go.
You just wrote your first program.
I wrote it?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
This is the code that you just wrote.
Very awesome.
I thought like code was like FBI hacker symbols and stuff.
A little bit of problem solving, a little bit of logic. It's like instructions.
Programming is a lot easier today.
Don't just play on your phone. Program it.
All right.
Awesome.
How does someone go about getting a job?
Maybe take an online class, find a class at a community college. Get one of the best paying jobs in the world.
I think medicine's moving into the whole computer age.
Technology touches every part of our lives. If you can create technology, you can change the world.
So we're excited that you are participating in today's Hour of Code.
We just did 2 lines of code.
3 lines of code!
4 lines.
7 lines.
5 lines.
3025 lines of code.
5 lines, 60 lines of code, 99 lines, 16 lines, 18 lines of code, 75 lines of code.
Doesn't matter how old you are.
The Hour of Code.
Yeah, programming a code.
The Hour of Code.
The Hour of Code.
The Hour of Code.
Whether you're a young man or a young woman, whether you live in a city or a rural area,
everybody in this country should learn how to program a computer.
And I just completed the
Hour of Code.
It's actually really easy to learn.
Girls should learn this too.
Understand that language that's gonna be the future.
Anyone can learn computer science. And you can learn too.
Jack Dorsey, Mark Zuckerberg, Bill Gates, all of y'all, I'm learning.
Give it a shot.
Yeah, now they can't tell me nothing. We give that to the people. Spread it across the country. Labels out here, now they can't tell me nothing. We give it to the people. Spread it across the country.